This is a clinical study. You isolate two groups, and you run a trial, and you build a grid of measures that we think are relevant to the disease based on some validation studies that were done in the past. And we run this, and if you do it successfully, you get this result, which shows that the people on the blue line did better than the people on the red line, and you really, really want to take this drug, because after 10 years of working in my field, we'd never seen anything like this, and you had to go take this drug, and many patients did. But we also don't practice medicine just based on clinical trials. The other evidence we use, and this is one of my favorite articles of all time, it is an article that evaluates all of the clinical studies that are used to demonstrate that parachutes can prevent death due to gravitational injury. Now, this is actually a great literature field. You can go back and look at it, because they argued that no doctor can, according to the rules of evidence, prescribe a parachute for anyone jumping out of an airplane. So the counters are kind of funny. First off, they did animal work. They threw sheep out of airplanes to see how many died. So they did an animal model, didn't have the SOD1 gene, but they did do animal models, and they jumped out of the airplanes. Now, what I like about this is, obviously, it's dumb. You should use parachutes, and we should do medicine that way. I mean, so you should do the things that are obvious. But there's a couple variables that I like. So one is, in World War II, about 1% of the people that jumped out of an airplane died. It's a pretty high adverse event rate, far worse than Tysabri. And in that case, what happened is, over the intervening years, we've moved that rate to zero. And the parachutes are much more effective and safer. They break fewer ankles. They have better capabilities. And somehow we managed to optimize something from a 1% death rate to zero without any double-blind placebo-controlled trials. We managed to figure it out. And I don't know how we did that, but we don't do that in medicine. But I will say the other kind of thing that seems obvious that's the problem is my father had a prophylactic bypass. This is a guy that biked to work 9 miles each day, fainted once, went for a cardiac workup, and Mass General did a bypass on him to prevent heart attacks. Because it's obvious, if your heart has 60% blockage, that you should fix it. Except that when you actually look at what happened, he never got on a bike again. He lost 6 months of the most productive parts of his life working on global warming, and did nothing to reduce his risk of death due to heart attacks. So what seems obvious is not. So you can't use the trial model, we'll talk about that in a second. You can't use the obvious model, because that doesn't work.